and the Tramp. Use your imagination. And I turned to Alan, as I often did, and I said what became a catchphrase for that summer. Alan, I don't think I can party tonight. And Alan looked at me that morning and he said,
oh my God, Clark. I had a doozy last night, buddy. I swallowed an entire mallard duck and I woke up in David Duchovny's garage. How'd your night end up, buddy?
I looked at him and I said, well, Al, it was eventful, but perhaps not that eventful. My night was tough to swallow as well. It was a crazy moment with an old friend of mine. We'd had feelings for each other for a really long time, and I'm not gonna lie to you, I don't want to be the one to kiss and tell, but we kissed. He exclaimed. And I replied, yeah, I did, Al. You know, we kissed, and as tends to be the case with a little kissing, complications arose. And the complications were as follows. She turned to me, she said, I love you. And I looked back at her, took a deep breath, said the first thing that came to mind, which was, I love you too. And she looked back at me, Al, and you know what she said? She said, Zach, don't just love me because you're lonely. And Alan said,
oh my God, don't just love me because you're lonely? That sounds like a song, Clark. We gotta write this song right now, bro. Come on!
And I was like, that I turned to Alan and I said, maybe you can help me with the first or the second verse.
Yeah, I think I could try. Should have felt the flame start flickering at my feet. Before you smelt the smoke on me.